Hey guys, in this video, we'll take a look at a couple key properties and formulas that will help you find derivatives in a much simpler way rather than using the definition every time. The first property we'll look at is differentiating a sum or a difference. Here's the property. Or we could write this in fraction notation, which would look like this. Our d of x here just signifies that you are taking the derivative with respect to the x. So over on the right here, we can see that we've taken the derivative of f with respect to x. And we can see here that we've taken the derivative of g with respect to x. So what this is the same property right here. So what this property is telling us is that when differentiating a function that has two terms being added or subtracted, you can take the derivative of the terms individually and simply put them back together with the correct sign. The next property we'll take a look at deals with factoring out a constant. What this property is telling us is that we can take the constant that is being multiplied by everything in that function and factor it out. So that when we just take the derivative of the function, then we just move that constant back in front so it stays the same. Now, before we go on to look at some examples of these properties being applied, I must first equip you with some derivative formulas so that you can actually find the derivative. Here's the first one. This formula shows us that the derivative of any constant is just zero. What this formula right here is telling us to do is to take our exponent and bring it down to multiply by our variable, then subtract 1 from the exponent. The n in our formula has to be a number, not a variable. The base number, however, must be a variable to be able to use the power rule, or else it would just be a constant, which we know is equal to 0 from our first property. All right, now let's take a look at a few examples. So, according to our first property, we are able to take the derivative of each term individually because each term is being added or subtracted. By looking at our function, we can see that we need to use the power rule on the three terms where we have an exponent with a variable in the base. And with our 8 here, that will just be 0 because it's a constant. So, when we apply our power rule, we'll bring down this exponent to multiply, then subtract 1 from our exponent. So anytime you take the derivative of a constant, you'll always replace it with c. And this will start to make sense when we start taking antiderivatives, which is another video. Now, we can go ahead and simplify this even further. The reason I wrote out 7 times 1 times x to the 0 is to show you why 7x becomes 7. We know that 7x has an exponent of 1, so when we bring that 1 down and multiply it times 7 and subtract 1, we're left with 0, and x to the 0 is 1, so that's why we're left with 7. This is true of any variable with an exponent of 1. You can just drop the variable and the derivative is just the remaining coefficient. Let's take a look at another example. This may seem a little scary. If you're anything like me, you're thinking, why on earth are there fractions and you didn't tell us what to do when there's a fraction? That's okay, and you're right. I haven't told you what to do yet. That's another video. However, we can rewrite this to get out of having to deal with fractions. If you recall, the exponent rule states that 1 over a to the n is the same thing as a to the negative n. So with this in mind, we can go ahead and rewrite our function. Now we can use our power rule and formula for a constant. Now, the reason our exponent here went from negative 80 to negative 81 is because we are subtracting negative 1 from negative 80, which gives us negative 81. And same thing here for our negative 13. Now, at this point, all I need to do is simplify my expression. And here is our final answer. Keep in mind, as you begin taking derivatives, oftentimes you can just rewrite them so that you're not having to work with something you don't know. I hope that this video was helpful. Be sure to check out more of our videos by subscribing to our channel below. See you guys next time.